Deutschland, über alles.
Hello guys, you are watching Binary Ninjas Tips and Tricks for Germany. This is Binary Ninja, and I want to discuss a matter that it's well, at least very important for me from the entertainment perspective. When you move to Germany or to any other country, there is something called internet lock or internet region lock. So, for example, if you want to watch videos or streaming or hear internet music from your country, you won't be able most of the time if you are accessing with an IP address from another country. So, for example, I came from the USA and I love to watch Netflix, and I watch a lot of TV shows, American TV shows, movies. I like to play video games with Americans. And here in Germany, TV most of the time is in German, and American shows are dubbed in German. Very, very few things are in the natural or original language. So when I came here, I first found that there was no Netflix at all in the beginning. So I looked for alternatives, and there was another service that is called Watchever. It's pretty good because it's basically Netflix, but there is a catch. Not all the shows are in the original language. Most of them are in German. So that was a problem for me. And also, they don't have the latest seasons. You have to wait more time to get the latest episodes, etc. So there are a few ways to get around this. There are three that I am aware of right now. The first one would be to get a VPN service. The VPN has an added bonus that makes all your traffic encrypted. So that is an added bonus for protection, and from security perspective, it's very good. The downside of that one is it's a bit slower because it's masking all your traffic and encrypting it. So if you have, for instance, 50 megabits per second internet, you will be browsing at 20 or less, so that's a problem. But if you have a pretty good internet, it's not such a problem for streaming or whatever. So I like it for many things. I will explain later. The second option would be to use a proxy. A proxy is just to use an IP address from another country to tell the service that you are accessing that you are in the other country. So it's kind of tricking the system. The downside of that one is that it's not encrypted, and it's also slower because you are going through a third-party server, and if the government or whoever wants to still watch your traffic, they can still do it. So I recommend that just for simple things such as browsing some news site that is blocked in the country or whatever. So that's the second option. The third option, that it's speed-wise, is the best. It's called Smart DNS. This is very simple to use. You just replace the IP address of your DNS for the IP address of the service provider. And what they do is they mask you as you were in the country, but you don't go through them, so the speed is not affected. So you can still keep your original internet speed. So I want to show you some examples. If you go to the website whatismyip.com, you can see this is my IP address. That for security reasons is blurred, but you can see here the country, and it says that I'm in Germany. So for the first option that I talked to you about, the VPN service, there are some options that I have tried. This one in particular I have tried, and it's very good. It's called TorGuard. The good thing about this one is that they have servers all around the world, in Holland, in US, in Mexico, in Spain, whatever. So you can switch from whichever server you want, depending on the situation or the content that you want to access, you can change it. And also they offer you from $10 a month a VPN proxy and a SOX proxy also to protect your torrents. I don't really recommend that. That's not legal. So whatever I'm showing you here is just to access legal content, content that you are paying for, but you cannot access because you're not in your country of origin. So you better watch out that. So this service TorGuard is good. As I told you, they offer you a list of servers. So for example here, we will try this, the proxy. You go here to connections and settings and enable the proxy. If you see the proxy is something torguard.tg, the port, they give you all that information and you get a login. So now that I have my proxy enabled, if I refresh this website, you can see that now I'm in Los Angeles, California in the US. So as simple as that, you can access content that you normally won't be able to access. So for example, you would like to watch the shows in ABC, and normally ABC post their shows 1 week later than they were aired in the US. So you can follow up your favorite shows here, and if you access them from outside the USA, you cannot watch them. So for example, let's try this episode, season 2, episode 2 of Marvel Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. And you can see it's streaming just as if we were in the US. So normally we would get an error here saying that it's not available in your country or something like that. So that's a very good thing about it. Also, you can watch live TV here, just as if you were.
The following episode is presented with limited commercials by Disney's Alexander and the Terrible, Horrible, No Good, Very Bad Day.
Let's do the exact same thing, but turning off the proxy. So you go again to abc.com. You choose the same show, even same episode. And there you go. You have an error here, that an error while loading this video, error code, you appear to be outside the United States or its territories. So there's a proxy. Proxy is the simplest to use. You just gotta pay for the service. There are many free proxy servers, but I don't really recommend you to do that because, as I said, it's not encrypted. So the provider of this free proxy may not be so ethical about it, and they may be watching what you're doing. So a proxy only service, a very good one, is this one, usproxy.tv, but it costs also around $10 per month. So that's why I recommend to get a full package of VPN proxy, etc. So you can subscribe here. There is even here an explanation of how a proxy server works, etc. So I will be putting down in the description all these resources, so you can explore and see which one works for you. There's also another website called ukproxy.tv, and it's a proxy specifically for the UK, so you can watch content from the UK. So now that we are over that, see if, as I turn off my proxy, here is Germany again. So the second option, that it's the VPN, I use this service TorGuard. So when you subscribe to the service, you can download an app that it's called Desktop, and it's a VPN client. So here you can choose which server you want to log in. You can see Belgium, Brazil, Canada, France, most of the big countries are here, even Spain, Mexico, Luxembourg, other countries are here. So I normally choose the United States, Dallas. You just choose here TCP and choose connect. Here they will ask you your login. This login, you get it naturally by paying the service and logging in to your service. So as you can see here, it's assigning an IP address. Here's my local IP, my remote IP, and now I'm connected, so you can just minimize this and we can go ahead and try something different. For example, I love this website, crunchyroll.com. It's to watch anime. It works in most of the countries, but most of the content is delayed for weeks in the US, outside the US. So for example, here we are. Here there was even a message. Oh, I cannot see it now. So, for example, I like, let me log in. I like a new anime that it's called Sword Art Online. So you will see, actually we can go to my queue. Here I have in my queue many websites, many animes. So I like Sword Art Online, so for example I want to watch this one. You can even watch in full HD, so it's pretty neat. Ah, here you can see the message. Due to licensing restrictions, ordered online. If I turn off my VPN, let's try for example Netflix. Right now we are accessing with the German IP address. And yeah, you can still log in. With your US account. But you won't see all the latest episodes. So for example, you can go to look for Revenge. I cannot even find the TV show, so I cannot find Revenge. So and connect with my VPN. I'm connected. You can check my IP address again. I have an American IP address now. So here we are, you can even see from the beginning that the main site is different. So here I look for Revenge. And here it is. So this is a very good way to keep up with your TV shows, with your movies. It just really pisses me off to be region locked for no reason. So this is a very good option. So for VPN, I can recommend you Torgard. I use it and it's very good. I have also tried Hotspot Shield, and both of these also even have apps for your smartphone, for your Android or iPhone, and you can even connect to the VPN with your cell phone, so you can stream Netflix in your cell phone, for example. Or if you just want to be more secure and access your bank account, you can use the VPN to be safer in the internet. So this is very, very interesting. For example, for the smart DNS, for example, overplays one of the services. The smart DNS, it's configured differently. You go to your network configurations, and here you go to Internet Protocol version 4 properties, and here instead of having obtained DNS server address automatically, just click here and put the DNS that is provided by the service that you hire for this. With this, you will still have a German IP address, but you will be able to access to US content or to other countries' content. But again, it's not encrypted. But the upside of this is that you don't lose any speed. So I hope this is useful for you, and please leave in the comments if you would like to see any more tips, or if you have any questions regarding these tips. I will put all these resources in the comments down below, and please remember to like the video if you like it, to share it, and please subscribe to my channel. I will be publishing another the next episode next Friday. Sorry, I'm a bit late this week, but I'm a bit sick. I have a cold, so. Please subscribe to my channel and tell to your friends, and see you next week. Thank you.